One of Alaska's most consistently explosive volcanoes currently has a little more than a 50% chance of erupting by the end of 2026 per the U.S. Geological Survey. What I am referring to is Mount Spurr, which is the closest active volcano to the major city of Anchorage. Yes, this is the same volcano that dumped a layer of ash on Anchorage in 1953 and 1992, and is actually showing increasing signs of unrest at the present. While the exact words of 50% chance of erupting by 2026 weren't directly said, something similar was implied when the U.S. Geological Survey and Alaska Volcano Observatory outlined three scenarios which might soon occur at this more than 11,000-foot-tall, glacier- and snow-covered volcano. They are as follows. Possibility 1. An explosive volcanic eruption occurs at the crater peak vent, which could even reach the size of a VEA-4 like the 1953 and 1992 eruptions, or be smaller. Possibility 2. No eruption happens, as the ongoing intrusion of magma fails to reach the surface, and activity declines back to background levels over a period of multiple months. Possibility 3. Instead of crater peak erupting, the first eruption in more than 5,000 years at the summit of Mount Spurr could occur, melting unusually large volumes of glacier ice and probably creating voluminous and lengthy lahars. These stated an equal chance of scenarios 1 and 2 occurring in the upcoming weeks to months, with a lesser chance of scenario 3 occurring. This translates to a slightly greater than 50% chance that Mount Spurr will fairly soon erupt, and since most periods of unrest at this volcano end or lead to an eruption within 2 to 3 years of its onset, and the fact that the current unrest began in April 2023, you can see where I get my 2026 figure from. So, what exactly is the current situation at Mount Spurr? First, here is what we are 100% sure of. Mount Spurr is undergoing a magmatic intrusion at the present, which at a minimum has risen to at least 2 to 3 miles below sea level at a location approximately 2 miles west of Mount Spurr's glaciated summit. This influx of fresh magma has triggered the ground overlying the body of magma to rise by about 2.4 inches or 6 centimeters, the formation of a heated liquid acid crater lake at its summit despite frigid cold temperatures there, and an increased rate of earthquakes in two clusters. The first cluster is occurring at 0 to 6 miles depth, while the second cluster is at 12 to 22 miles depth. While the second cluster marks earthquakes associated with magma rising upwards into the crust, the shallower cluster represents magma pooling and then continuing to rise from Mount Spurr's magma chamber at approximately 6 miles depth. Now, since there is a large room for interpretation here, the following is merely my opinion of what I think is occurring. Around February 3rd, a third new cluster of earthquakes, almost all of which were very small in magnitude, began striking beneath the vent of Crater Peak. This to me suggests that magma has finally found a dominant pathway to the surface and may currently be as little depth as actual sea level. However, these types of earthquakes have recently declined and no elevated gas emissions have yet been detected, so magma still might be at around 1.4 miles below sea level at its shallowest. In other words, it is not exactly clear what will happen next. Crater Peak has erupted more than 30 times during the last 5,000 years, while its summit in the same time span has erupted 0 times, with all of these eruptions being explosive and seemingly ranking on the Volcanic Explosivity Index as a 2, 3, or 4. There is no reason to think why the next eruption, if it does occur, wouldn't also rank within an order of magnitude of its 1953 and 1992 eruptions, which are both assigned VEIs of a 4. Both of these eruptions were subplinian, generating hours-long sustained eruption columns that reached up to 70,000 feet high in 1953 and 49,000 feet high in 1992. Something similar could be expected during a subsequent eruption, causing ash to fall up to 300 miles away, primarily to the north and east. Widespread air traffic disruptions could also occur, as it is unsafe and dangerous to fly aircraft in conditions where they would face many ash particulates. Such an eruption could start slow and then see multiple hours-long bursts of powerful explosive activity, even generating pyroclastic flows, with periods of lesser activity between major explosive episodes that could last multiple months. While not listed in official hazard maps, I have noted the presence of 9 structures which could theoretically be placed in potential danger during an extreme lahar event, in my opinion. Mount Spurr possibly erupting in the near future is not a reason to panic or cancel any plans to travel to Alaska. Just plan accordingly, knowing something like this might happen, and bring an N95 mask to reduce particulate exposure if an explosive eruption from Spurr occurs. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Hopfen Bauer, for supporting my work.